Okay, 5 picks, let's go. There we go, we got it. It's on. What's up, peeps? It is downtown for a brand new episode of Supercard, and in this one, I'm going to be getting my WWE Supercard SummerSlam 17 freebie. So, we got 100 new cards today from, of course, the SummerSlam 17 tier, but that's not the only new thing added to this update. There's some more stuff in there, so let me quickly go over the patch notes here. So on top of the 100 new SummerSlam 17 cards added to the game, they've also of course added in some new attitudes. Who really cares about that? Card packs have also been added, updated. King of the Ring energy can now be gained by watching an advertisement. So that's interesting. You can now get energy cards for your King of the Ring by watching an ad. I like that. The more watching ad options to get stuff in the game there is, the better I think it is. For instance, I'm still waiting for a feature where you can watch an ad to get some training done for your cards, because I don't like training my cards. Takes way too long. But anyways, moving on, support cards will no longer count as your tier's guaranteed pull. Thank you for this. For a while now, people have been pulling support card left and right, one after the other, and it would count as your pull. So it would take a long time for you to get another pull, a pull that you actually want, a superstar. This was especially the case in the 33 tier. People were pulling so many support cards. People were playing the game, of course, to advance in the game, get better decks, but then they're pulling all these support cards, and how can you really advance in the game if all you're getting is support cards? And it seemed like they had increased the rate at which you pulled support cards. Well, now what this means is that when you get a support card, that doesn't count as your pull. So that's a big plus right there, big change. I remember it was even worse in the past. In the past, you could actually get a support card as your freebie. They thankfully fixed that, so you would no longer get support cards as your freebie, but then the problem was when you would pull a support card, it would count as your pull for that tier. So I'm absolutely 100% behind this change. This was a good move right there. And then last, but hopefully not least, depending on how it works out or how well the improvements are, it says various networking improvements have been made to better optimize WWE Supercard. As you all know, all of you who play Supercard or have played Supercard for a good amount of time, there's a ton of waiting on network messages that you're gonna get, especially when events starts and such and a lot of people are playing at the same time. Hopefully, this greatly reduces that, because this game's been out for 3 years. They just, you know, celebrated their 3-year anniversary like 2 days ago or so. And for all these 3 years, we've had to wait a ton on the network. We've probably spent hours waiting on a network for those of us who are still playing to this day in the top tier. And now for what you're actually here for, let's get that freebie. But first off, look at this Roman Reigns card. It's a good looking Roman Reigns card. I would actually want that card. So if I get that as my freebie, I'd be cool with it. That's probably the best, just from what I see right here. That looks like the best Roman Reigns picture out there in the game. But anyways, instead of going through WoW mode, I'll go through Rank mode just because we get 5 picks out of a win. So less matches that I have to go through before getting my freebie. Although I have to wait a bit more, I'll go with Ranked. Okay, we're matched up. Would I win? Is this a bot? Is this not a bot? We'll see. But chances are, it's a bot. But at the same time, the tier just dropped, the update just dropped, so chances are, well, it might actually be a real person. We'll see. Oh, this is not a bot, but he has left the match. And this is a power and toughness match, so I'm gonna win this one because Jinder Mahal happens to be power and toughness. So the Maharaja defeats Samoa Joe. And then a female power charisma match. My Carmella card isn't fully trained, so I'm gonna go with Bayley on this one. All right, Bayley versus Mae Young, but Bayley gets the boost right there, so we get the win. It's a guaranteed win. Now we just want to make this a perfect match, so let's go with Jeff Hardy and Matt Hardy for the tag team, and we get this one, so we're gonna get 5 picks out of this match. That might be enough to get the freebie right after this match. If it's not, we're gonna go through another match. So, we win 3-0. This is one of the few times where I actually face off against a human opponent. Kind of, because he left the match. That's the thing, most of the time you're facing off against the bot, a CPU, and then when you face off against a real opponent, like 90% of the time, they disconnect. What's going on with that? So, let's go. 5 picks. Are we gonna get it right here? And charge cards, of course, because I just joined a team battleground. Actually, not just joined. It's been about an hour, actually a bit more than an hour, but whatever. So, two more picks, not looking likely like we're gonna get our freebie right here. Chances are I'm gonna have to go through one or two more matches for this. Yeah, so, match number two, let's go, let's start the search. So we're taking on King of Wrestling. For some reason, the first time I saw it, I read it as King of Raisins. So that's a win. Now, just wanna get this perfect match. So toughness and charisma, gonna go with Jeff Hardy on this one. And we get it, because we're facing off against a normal card. So, we didn't get it this time. We're gonna have to go through another match. Let's go. So, while I'm on my way to getting my freebie here, what did you guys get as your freebie? Let me know in the comment section. Did you get a good card or not so good card? Let me know who it was and if you're happy with it. So, female power and toughness, of course, gonna go with Bayley. Not gonna use the support card this time. We get it regardless, so that's good. Bayley versus Naomi. Bayley takes this. And then moving on, it's going to be a speed and charisma card. If I had Shawn Michaels right now, I would have went with Shawn, but I don't. So I'm just going to go with Matt Hardy on this one. So there we go. That's a win. And now we just got to get that perfect match three times in a row. We're going to go with Carmella. Don't have a charisma support at the moment, but we still get this one. So there we go. It's the third time. Going to be the charm. We're about to find out if we get that freebie right now. Okay, five picks, let's go. There we go, we got an I'm sure Enzo has to be one of the worst cards in the tier. This is pretty bad. I was hoping, like, there's so many cards in the tier. Why did I have to get Enzo out of all the cards? Last tier, 33, I got the absolute worst card in the tier, James Ellsworth. This time around, I'm not sure if Enzo is the worst card out there, but I'm pretty sure he's one of the worst cards out there. Just looking at the stats, he already looks like a bad card. The picture ain't bad though, but the stats look bad, and I'm pretty sure he's one of the worst cards out there. So, on his own, as a single right now, I'm not really happy with this. Actually, I'm not happy at all with this, but on the bright side, though, since he's probably one of the weaker cards, chances are he's going to be a pro soon, just like the James Ellsworth card. I was bummed out at first, because I got the worst card in the tier, but in the beginning of a tier, they tend to give out the weaker cards first in the Ring Dominations and Road to Glory. So, hopefully there's something to look forward to, and that is a pro and so on more from one of the first Ring Dominations or Road to Glories. I hope, because if he doesn't end up a pro, then this really sucks. So let me just get through these last remaining cards right here, and Enzo Amore. And the thing is too with Enzo, is there's all these rumors that he might be sent back down to NXT. So I don't know, he's even gonna be in the company much longer. Apparently he's got all this heat backstage. So yeah, it looks cool. It's a cool looking card, but stats wise, probably not so good of a card. Once again, in the comment section, let me know who you got. Two tiers in a row now, I've gotten, you know, two of the worst cards, but it might be a pro. That's the one good thing about it. Anyways, freebie aside, guys, I'm in a team battleground right now against Big Rack Attack. Let's go ahead and check out my deck. I've already asked my teammates who has the best deck, and apparently I've got the best deck in the team. So, you know what? This would not be a smart idea to reveal on video since the team battleground hasn't started yet. Because the guys we're facing off against here contacted me on Twitter, so they know who I am. They could see this video. I'm not going to give them any advantage. But hey, good luck to you guys, but I'm not going to show you guys what I get right here because I'm posting this video up today before the prep phase ends. Now, what's interesting with the SummerSlam 17 tier is that the rewards are a bit different compared to the previous tiers. For instance, in the gold pack, you have absolutely no chance of getting a SummerSlam card. It doesn't go from 33 to SummerSlam 17. You're just going to get a 33 card, even though in the picture right here, it shows a SummerSlam card. So this should probably change that. It shows a SummerSlam card or a 33 card, but if you read the description, it's only a 33 card. And then for the Platinum Pack, you can get a 33 card to a SummerSlam 17 card. Now, I'm talking about the top reward here. I know you get two superstars on top of that that go from Ultimate to 33, but as far as the top reward in the Platinum Pack, it goes from 33 to SummerSlam 17, so it's not a guaranteed SummerSlam 17 card. And I think that's for the better, because this way, people, we don't run into the same problem as quick as we did in the 33 tier. Because the problem with the 33 tier is that it was so easy to get all these 33 cards, all these 33 pros through Team Battleground, because it was so easy to just do Team Battlegrounds all the time and get Platinum Packs or Gold Packs and get your cards that way pretty easy and pretty quick. So this, I think, will slow down the problem. In 33, so many of us were at the top. We didn't really need any more pros or any more events, so we didn't have anything to do. That's why we wanted a new tier, so bad. Now, on top of the Platinum Packs change, you also notice if you go to the BP store, there's no SS17 packs to be found. So they didn't add it from the very beginning of the tier, which makes me think they're gonna go about it the same way they go about it with the Fusion Chamber. If you guys haven't noticed yet, the Fusion Chamber only adds the latest and greatest tier towards the end of that tier. Once that tier has already been established, that's when it gets added to the Fusion Chamber and you can get Fusion cards of that tier. And I think that's going to be the same thing here with the BP store when it concerns the SummerSlam 17 card. And once again here, it's probably for the better. Even though I myself was saving up battle points for some 17 packs in the BP store and I recommended people to do the same, I can totally see why they did this, seeing as how people complained in the 33 tier about how easy it was to reach the top and then you have nothing to do. So this reduces that issue. And also, let's be real, it's probably also to push the packs that actually cost some real money. Now, as you can see, I've only got 31k battle points, and that's because I saved a couple Platinum Packs. Now, I didn't make the same mistake that I did last time and save up 8 or 9 of them. I've only got just a few of them saved up, so let's go ahead and open those up. Gonna go through these a lot quicker. Neville, alright. And then we get some battle points. Come on, skip. Why is the Battle Points card animation so slow? I don't need to see that. Okay, Ultimate card, cool. And another Ultimate card. These Ultimate cards are just going to go towards the Fusion Chamber or towards maxing out some stronger cards. Platinum Pack number 2, we get Nikki Bella, okay. And then we get Braun Strowman, followed by Dolph Ziggler. And who's this? Oh yeah, Battle Points, forgot. And we got to sit through the Battle Points animation once again. Man, next update. Freaking give us the option to skip this. We don't need this long animation to see some points adding up. Come on, winning on network. What happened? I thought the update improved the winning on network issues. So let's go ahead and open up the last Platinum Pack. We get Kevin Owens and Nikki Bella, okay. Followed by Kevin Owens and the battle points. So there we go, opened up the Platinum Packs, didn't make the same mistake that I did last time where the game deleted some of my packs. If you guys haven't checked that video out, I'll put a card up. I basically show you in that video what not to do if you don't want to lose some valuable packs with some valuable cards in them. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the video. If you guys are wondering what the event card is going to be, it's going to be Kurt Angle. WWE.com, I think, messed up and they put it up in one of their galleries for the SummerSlam 17 cards. I'll put up the picture on the video. So that's pretty cool. Looking forward to getting that card. Been wanting an Angle card since he made his return in the WWE. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, click the like button down below. Subscribe for more videos and click that notification bell to be notified for every single upload. With that said, I'm out. See ya.